Hey folks, it's been a long time without an update as I've been keeping myself busy with a lot of work stuff. I thought it was about time that I showed some actual progress. And even though I've been kind of all of my headspace absorbed by this work project, I've got a few more features added, and especially in the last few days. So I thought I'd give you a quick tour through that. One of the things those following the repo might have noticed is that I've merged the development branch back into master. I kind of got to the point where I thought this is an alpha. It's silly that I'm kind of developing something alongside. Just pushed it back into master and I can just fix bugs there. There's a one standout bug that's there at the moment, which is the defgl struct complains, gives some warnings that certain functions are defined even though they are. I think this is an eval when issue. I need to go have a look at that. But there should be no actual blockers. One of the things I've been meaning to add for a while is support for multipass rendering. And for that, we need frame buffer objects. So I've finally got round to that. And this is a very preliminary kind of setup. All I've done now is expose, in a slightly lispy way, the frame buffer objects. And I'm then going to go back and do some real work on the abstraction. So you can see here, I create another texture called FBO texture, which is the same size as the window and has a standard format. We create an FBO and then we attach the texture to the FBO in the color attachment slot, the first one. Now up here in the step demo function, we're currently running the ripple with wobble texture that you're actually seeing on there. That's the one I showed in another one of my videos. What we're going to do now, if I uncomment this, is with the new FBO bound, we're going to render ripple with wobble again, and because it's inside that with bind FBO block, this will be captured to a texture. And then we're going to run the throw it on screen shader, or pipeline rather, which is here. All this does is draws a quad and blitz the texture onto it. And so if I recompile this, you should see the same scene again. So this is a very tiny proof of concept, as far as I've got so far. I've got a lot of refactoring to do and making especially Varjo, the shader compiler, more consistent with return values and things like this. And getting this stuff tidied up and abstracted well will be part of that job. That's coming soon. Okay, what I've also added rather is buffer back textures. So before you're able to do things like make texture and specify, so if I do dimensions, and let's make a 64 by 64 texture, and the internal format will be RGBA8. If we do this, and then I can call text ref, we were seeing before that what it would give you is a GPU array that was backed by a texture. Now, what's really nice is the abstractions are all in place, so all I needed to do for make texture was add an extra keyword called buffer storage. Let's see if we've got that there. Say T, this gives you a texture buffer. And if you take a text ref of this, you get a GPU array backed by buffer, which is the same kind of GPU array as you'd be using for creating streams from, because it's the same object internally in GL, so we expose it using the same abstraction. Which also means you can just, as with normal textures, just GL pull them and get all the data, etc., etc. It's all fairly standard stuff, but it's really nice to see these things staying very cohesive and coherent. In Varjo, the compiler there, if I go to that package, I've been working on multiple value return because this is something that Lisp has, well, common Lisp at least, and is kind of available in GLSL in the form of out variables. So all I do is when I detect that you have a multiple value return, these get added as out vars, and then temporary variables are created where you call the function from. It's actually a lot clearer if I just show something. I think back here somewhere I have a little example def shader. Here we are. So if I compile this, you can see we've got a local function called fun, which just returns three integers. Notice at the moment we still have to write return explicitly, which is crap, and that will be going in the next few days. So if I just compile this, and then we'll get the GLSL code of that. Notice that the function fun returns an int, which is the first argument, so that would be the number one in this case, but also has two outvars specified. This will be for 2 and 3. They all get set up here, and 0 is returned. And then, as you can see from where we actually called the function, these two variables will be populated. And then you can use things like destructuring bind to actually capture those and get at all this data that's been passed back. So that's very cool, very happy with that. The other thing that's happening in Varjo at the moment is I'm working on implicit uniforms. What this is going to allow you to do is you will be able to specify a global variable, let's just say loop. And if this was defined in the CPU side of your common-lisp program, it will get captured and automatically converted into a uniform variable that's passed up each time this function's called. This is one of those things that has a slight overhead, depending on how well I can memoize data. But as far as making shaders feel integrated with Lisp, it's second to none. It feels absolutely fantastic. Now, I'm running into a few issues with this at the moment because compiling of the Lisp to GLSL happens at runtime, and that means I only get details of these implicit uniforms at runtime. But I'm doing most of the inlining of uniform uploads at macro expansion time, at compile time. So I've got a few little things to do there to really make that integrated and fast, because I really don't want to pay any more penalty than we have to, because I want to keep these shaders nice and quick. Other than that, what am I working on? Not much, really. I think I need to really nail implicit uniforms and frame buffers and show some more complicated examples of these textures. I'm hoping now we can do a lot more with textures, using them for compute as well. There's going to be a lot of bugs in here, a lot of things to iron out, but I hope I've kind of excited a few people out there, and I'll be back very soon with some more. Ciao.